Welcome back to BaldHeaded Metal, guys. My name is Joseph. Today, we're doing a reaction to a band, actually, I picked out. It's a band that I've known about, but never actually sat down and listened. And I don't know what the exact reason was, just kind of how it turned out. And it's a band, HYPOCRISY, with their new single, Chemical Whore. So I want to get right into it. I know it's a Swedish death metal band. I know they spent some time in Florida. I kind of know very brief history of them, and I might have heard a song or two here and there, but perhaps I don't think I ever sat down and listened to a full album. I think this is going to be a nice start to get back into these guys. Let's see what we got here. I like me some death metal. 2020, approximately $1.7 million have been spent on medicines for me. A pharmaceutical company, kind of a critique. Right away, I'm going to stop it here. Just I can see the visual imagery is going to be this is going to be a kick-ass music video. I can tell right away. And a chemical whore, pharmaceutical company, nice little kind of play on words going on here, right? Kind of they're already putting their message forward, what they think about the whole being addicted to medication or self or over being over medicated, especially in a country like United States. I didn't know it was a melodic death metal band, which is cool. I like the sound. I like the idea behind the song. I might not always agree with the way they express themselves, but at the very least, I think it's quite accurate to United States, where it's a matter of in schools, I would say, in my opinion, like what I've experienced in schools, in medicine, where you're trying to get some help. It feels like they're first one to get money from you. And secondly, they want to help you. It's always kind of the feeling. In school, I never felt like their concern was my education. Their concern was is that I keep paying for that education, you know? And it's the same thing whenever I would go to a doctor. I always question my doctors, at least at the basic question, why am I doing this procedure? Do I really need to do this? Can I avoid any kind of invasive surgery, anything that if I ever need something like that? Yeah, and I've heard from there was a comparison done between Europe and United States in terms of how expensive medicine is, and United States is like one of the most expensive countries for medication, for any kind of medical procedure. But I don't know. That's where I live. That's all I know, kind of. You know, as I'm thinking about the song, I like the main riff of the song, and I like the all the guitar work, and it's kind of a simple song. It's not, you know, it's not trying to be like a super complex, full of various riffs and solos, you know, left and right. But it's addictive riffs and interesting riffs, and I would say that I like this song. But yeah, like the lyrics, I think a lot of metal bands tend to have opinions, and they have very, very strong opinions on the various subject matter, and it can influence, you know, some people how they believe by listening to bands that they adore. And as careful as we should be with medication or over medication or over, you know, like overuse of medication or something like that, there's also some people that, you know, literally they need it to survive, whether it be depression, whether it be some kind of life-threatening health problem that you might have. And this song is only hitting one side of the story, in my opinion. This song, from a music standpoint, I like his vocals. He has a nice deep growl in there. It was good. The music video is actually really good. It's just I'm not 100% on board with kind of the one-sided nature of this. It's like all I can do, of course, this song came out in this year, so I'm sure it's in some shape or form related to what's happening with COVID, obviously. And the reason why I tend to stay a little bit back from this kind of conversation or this kind of extreme point of view is I don't like either extremes. But all I can say is, you know, it's like a lot of people come out and just start questioning every single thing. It's like, you became a doctor in the last 3 months. Researching like 5 articles that you've read. I don't know. There's a sensible way of approaching things, and I think I feel like the world in general has become more and more polarized, and everybody's just like, you either on this side or you're on this side. Either you reject all medication and everything, or you're taking everything and just trust blindly. It's like just such big extremes. So I tend to not when it's like, especially times when I get talking to my clients as a personal trainer, I tend to stay back from those kind of conversations because I'm like, you know what? I'm okay with disagreeing with you. We can still be friends. I'm fine with that, but I really don't want to get it in with you. I don't need that stress in my life. I'll leave it like that. But from a perspective of a metal song, I think the visual imagery in the music video is great. I think the music was great. I wish there was a solo in there, but other than that, it's like it's by the books, fun kind of a melodic death metal song. I'll put it like that. I do want to hear more from this band. Can you guys recommend me something that's a little bit more, I guess maybe some of their classics that would be really good songs to check out from HYPOCRISY. Other than that, guys, make sure you keep it metal out there and have a good day.